acid-base balance is the process by which the body maintains a proper acid-base equilibrium. This refers to the degree of acidity and alkalinity in the body. For our organs and systems to function properly, the body must maintain acid-base homeostasis by regulating the levels of acids and bases in the blood and tissues. The body does this through several mechanisms, including respiration, excretion, and buffer systems. In this video, we will discuss the role of acid-base balance in the body and how it is maintained. We will also touch on some disorders that can occur when this balance is disturbed. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, acid-base balance involves maintaining adequate levels of acids and bases in the blood and body tissues, which is measured by the pH scale. This scale ranges from 0, which is very acidic, to 14, which is very alkaline. Blood in the human body is typically slightly more alkaline than acidic. Therefore, a normal pH ranges from 7.35 to 7.45. The goal of the body is to maintain the blood pH as close to 7.4 as possible. So how is acid-base analysis performed? An acid-base analysis can be performed by looking at the results of an arterial blood gas, or ABG. It's a test that measures the blood levels of oxygen, carbon dioxide, bicarbonate, and acid-base balance in the body. A sample of blood is collected from a syringe, and the results are used to assess how well oxygen is being distributed throughout the body. It also looks at how well carbon dioxide is being removed. ABG interpretation is a very important skill for respiratory therapists and medical professionals because it helps with the assessment of the patient's acid-base balance. If the pH is outside of the normal range, the patient may require other interventions such as oxygen therapy or mechanical ventilation. Now let's take a look at the acid-base normal values. To better understand the key elements of an ABG test, it is important to know the definition of the values that are being measured. pH refers to the acid-base balance of the blood. The partial pressure of oxygen, or PaO2, refers to the amount of oxygen in arterial blood. And the partial pressure of carbon dioxide, or PaCO2, refers to the amount of carbon dioxide in arterial blood. Bicarbonate, or HCO3, refers to the total amount of CO2 that is transported in the blood. And oxygen saturation, or SpO2, refers to the amount of hemoglobin in the blood that is saturated with oxygen. And after an arterial blood sample is collected, it should be analyzed and interpreted by the practitioner. Normal acid-base results should fall within the following ranges: pH of 7.35 to 7.45, PaO2 of 75 to 100, PaCO2 of 35 to 45, bicarbonate of 22 to 26, and an oxygen saturation of 94 to 100%. The human body strives to regulate the amount of carbon dioxide and bicarbonate in the blood in order to keep the pH within the normal range. So how is blood pH regulated? Our blood pH is regulated by the lungs, kidneys, and buffer systems. The lungs help with ventilation and oxygenation. They provide the blood with oxygen during inhalation while removing carbon dioxide during exhalation. The kidneys help to regulate blood pH by excreting acids or bases in order to maintain a proper balance. Buffer systems help maintain proper pH balance by guarding against sudden swings in acidity and alkalinity, which means that we now need to discuss the acid-base disorders. There are two types of abnormalities when it comes to maintaining acid-base balance: acidosis and alkalosis. Acidosis means that the blood has either too much acid or not enough bases, which results in a decreased pH. Alkalosis means that the blood has too many bases or not enough acids, which results in an increased pH. The two types of acid-base disorders include respiratory and metabolic. Metabolic acidosis or alkalosis occurs when there is an imbalance in the production of acids or bases that results from a lack of excretion by the kidneys. Respiratory acidosis or alkalosis occurs when the lungs are removing too much or too little carbon dioxide due to a condition of the lungs. The steps for analyzing acid-base balance include the following. Step 1, collect and analyze an ABG sample. Step 2, determine if the pH is alkalotic or acidotic. Step 3, determine if the issue is respiratory or metabolic related. Step 4, determine if it's compensated or uncompensated. And step 5, perform the treatment modalities recommended by the physician. This analysis involves learning the process of ABG interpretation, which is one of the most valuable skills of respiratory therapists and students. We have other videos and resources on our channel and website, so definitely check those out if you want to learn more. And if you do want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you'll enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.